Chad Wien, Superintendent of Mad River Local Schools. Our video blog today is about the GWOC and our move into the GWOC for the 16-17 school year. Joining me today is Eric Sparr, Commissioner from the GWOC, and Paul Neves, Athletic Director for Stebbins High School. So Paul, we've had a lot of upgrades in our facilities. We're really looking forward to our move to the GWOC. What are some things that we can expect next year, moving to the GWOC, especially with these new facilities that we have?
Well, first of all, it's a very exciting time for not only the school, but the community. We're very fortunate to be accepted into the great conference the GWOC is. One of the exciting things that I think is great for our community and our kids is just the familiarity. I think a lot more people in our community are going to be familiar with the schools that we're playing in our, especially in our side with Fairborn, Xenia, Trotwood, and West Carrollton. The schools are very similar in school size as well as community makeup, and I believe that's going to allow for us to be very competitive and give us the opportunity to not have so much travel time. And like I said, our students, our community will be very familiar and create a lot of great rivalries.
Mm-hmm. And that's one thing that I noticed with our league and the way it's set up for next school year. It looks like some of those natural rivalries that we had in the past will be able to come back, especially with like Fairborn and Xenia being new, but proximity-wise, it's really not that far away. So that's really exciting to me.
Yeah, like I said, I think our kids are really excited as well. We've continued to play Xenia, Fairborn, West Carrollton, a lot of the GWOC schools. Even though we weren't affiliated with the conference, we've still been able to continue to play those due to the location and the history of it. So, like I said, with the new stadium and a lot of upgrades to baseball, softball that we've been able to do, I think we're a good fit. We obviously are excited that they wanted us to be a part of that, and we're looking forward to many years in the future.
Mm-hmm. And one thing I noticed about the GWOC, and you and I did a lot of analysis going into the league next school year, as far as the teams that we've played, we've been very competitive against the GWOC teams.
Yeah, I think the big misconception out there is that we're going to have to go out and play the larger Division I schools on day in and day out. That's not the case. We really like the way that they set it up. We still want to be able to play those schools because they are members of the conference, but the divisions really set up well for us because, like I said, we're going to be very competitive. The communities are very much alike, not just the schools, as where maybe we weren't so much with some of the other schools that we were playing in our current conference. So competitive-wise, if you look at some of our we've had great games with Fairborn, great games with Xenia, great games with West Carrollton. Same thing with Trotwood. We've competed in all those sports. So I feel as the athletic director that this move is not only beneficial for us, but, obviously we fit well in that side of the league.
Mm-hmm. And speaking of the GWOC in the league, Eric, we're really excited to be a part of the GWOC, and there's just a prestige to that conference. Can you talk to us a little bit about the conference in general?
Yeah, I mean, the conference has a pretty fine history in terms of what we've done, success, both at the district level, state level, things of that nature. It's very prestigious. There's buy-in from the communities. There's buy-in from the schools, from administrative staffs. It's just something that has evolved over the years. When we put the conference together, initially we were looking at a 14-team conference. It has expanded. And we've never really had to sell ourselves. It's just been something that the schools and the communities have bought in on. And when you look at our current structure, our current alignment, it benefits not just the student athletes, but the communities and just the whole process from the educational process to the athletic participation. It's been a good fit, recognized at the state level. And we're just really excited about having Stebbins and Tip join next year. And the structure and the format that we have, I think, would be beneficial to Stebbins.
Mm-hmm. And, Mr. Neves talked a little bit about the facility upgrades. How would the facilities compare to the other GWOC schools?
Well, I'm really excited about the stadium turf. Not going to lie about that one. When we were talking to the administrators, one of the things that as we were going through this process that we looked at was the facilities. And I would say that Mad River Local Schools and Stebbins obviously has the facilities that will be second to none. I mean, when you look at the upgrades that we have this year and what is going to be offered next year, really excited about that. I think the students and the community will be very proud of that investment. And I think when the more exciting for me is when the other schools come here to visit us, they'll see what we have to offer. And I think that's pretty exciting.
Yeah. Well, not only do we have an amazing facility, I feel like for the first time in a long time since the MML, we're in a Dayton league. And that's exciting to me to be able to play in a Dayton league versus a league that was more of a Springfield-based league and just really engage in the region as far as athletics and that. I'm so excited about showcasing what we have. I'm so excited about our student athletes here at Stebbins High School, and we're just very excited to be part of the GWAC next year. Eric, Paul, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thank you.
I got